University of Dayton. This is Julie Dillenberg. I'm the Director of Religious Education at St. Patrick's Church in Joliet. And I am standing in St. Patrick's. I'm in front of the beautiful image of Our Lady of Guadalupe. And I'm here to talk about common prayers of the church. Now, you probably know some of the common prayers of the church. One would be the Our Father. Another would be the Hail Mary. And another would be the Glory Be, also known as a doxology. Now, where can you find all those prayers? You can find them in the beautiful devotion of the Rosary. And in the Rosary, we say the Our Father as we begin each decade, and each decade consists of 10 Hail Marys. So if you would like to learn those prayers by heart, the best way to do it is repetition. And repetition can be found in the Rosary. I taught second grade for 20 years here, and my little students, we used to say the act of contrition before we left each day. And they did not know the act of contrition the first day of school. But by the second week of school, they could all say it by heart. So repetition is really important. Now, I mentioned the act of contrition. That's an important prayer because it tells God how sorry we are for the things that we did wrong during the day. I like my students to say the act of contrition at the end of the day because before we prayed it, we always would kind of think about all the things we did that day that maybe weren't in line with God's teachings. So I would ask them at the end of the day, did you always behave as God would want you to behave? And what did you do today? And just kind of think about it. And so before we pray the act of contrition or prayer of sorrow, sorrow for our sins, we would do that. And that is a perfect prayer for you to pray at night before you go to bed. Now, I mentioned I was a second grade teacher here for 20 years, but I've been the director of religious education for 18 years. And we found in our classrooms that the best way for the students also to learn their prayers is through repetition, of course, but it also is good for the students to have what we call a prayer listener. That's someone who takes them out into the hallway and listens to their prayers and helps them and guides them and listens to how they say their prayers and helps them learn their prayers. So that's another way you can help students learn their prayers. A way that you can help your own children or children in the classroom say learn their prayers by heart is by the Rosary, like I said earlier. Now, I know a lot of people who know the Our Father because it's in the Bible. Jesus taught us, and he said, when you pray, pray like this, and he taught the Our Father. But did you also know that the Hail Mary is in the Bible and that you can find it there? When the angel Gabriel greets Mary to tell her that she is going to be the mother of God, she starts the Hail Mary. And when Mary goes to visit her cousin Elizabeth, Elizabeth greets Mary and also says part of the Hail Mary. So the Hail Mary can also be found in the Bible, so it also is a biblical prayer. So when you are saying the Rosary, remember you're saying the Our Father, which Jesus taught us, which is in the Bible, which is in the Gospel of Matthew, and you're also saying the Hail Mary, which is also found in the Bible. So that's something you might be surprised to learn. I am going to tell you a little bit about a Rosary Club that I have. And in our Rosary Club, it's so important that the children learn the prayers by repetition, but it's also important to me that they learn the mysteries that are in the Rosary. The Rosary contains 20 mysteries. And you might say, well, what is that? Well, the mysteries are things that happened in the life of Christ and Mary. There's joyful mysteries, there's sorrowful mysteries, glorious mysteries, and Pope John Paul II, now Saint Pope John Paul II, added the luminous mysteries, which are said on Thursdays. The mysteries really, really are what you concentrate on when you say the Rosary. So when you're praying the Rosary and you're learning your prayers by heart, by repeating them over and over again, you're concentrating on these beautiful events in the life of Christ and Mary. For instance, the joyful mystery, the very first joyful mystery is the Annunciation, where the angel Gabriel comes and visits Mary. And when the angel Gabriel visits Mary, he tells her that she is going to be the mother of God. And Mary, of course, gives her fiat and says, yes, I am the handmaid of the Lord. And when you say that first decade of the rosary, of the joyful mysteries, you concentrate on that, you meditate on that, you just fill your whole mind up with that beautiful scenario, that beautiful event. So as I end this talk, I am going to pray an Our Father, a Hail Mary, and a Glory Be on this beautiful rosary I have. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. God bless you.